Welcome at the video, the second video of regression. And in this video we will discuss moderation and mediation using the same data set that we used in the last video. So if you still are unsure about what simple regression, multiple regression and mean centering does, please watch the first video. So moderation, or some people call it an interaction effect, it actually can be shown within, you know, two nominal variables, for instance country and type of movie, or an interaction between country and budget, for instance, which is an interval variable, or between two interval variables. We will discuss all of these in this video. Now, what is the difference between moderation and mediation? Conceptually, these two models test a different relationships. A moderation, it tests whether the relationship between X and Y differs for different levels of Z. While mediation, it actually wants to know, in mediation you can test whether the relationship between X and Y can be partially or totally explained by a third variable Z. Now, to make it more clear, I have some examples. So for instance, with moderation, it could be that the concern about the world's environmental issues leads to a certain level of willingness to pay for green products. However, this relationship might differ between countries. So maybe in Western countries, this has a higher, stronger relationship than in non-Western countries. Another example would be that where a budget for a movie leads to a certain revenue of the movie. We expect a positive relationship. The more budget, the more revenue a movie makes. However, this revenue, this relationship might differ between different countries. One example of mediation could be where the relationship to X and Y, so income and happiness, is mediated by the perceived ability to meet everyday life necessities. So income, a higher income leads to a higher level of happiness. However, part of this relationship can be explained by the perceived ability to meet everyday life. So if income leads to a higher level of happiness, so the more income one gathers, the more happy one becomes, this relationship might get stronger for those who have the perceived ability that they are able to meet everyday life necessities, or become weaker, meaning that this perceived ability to meet everyday life necessities can explain partly the relationship between income and happiness. So mediation is really more about causation between the variables, or how to explain a direct relationship, than whether this direct relationship differs between different groups of people or different levels of a variable, as we do in moderation. Between two nominal variables, so here's an example of that, where the X variable is the genre of the movie, which can be a horror, action, and we created a dummy variable where we only want to compare two genres, two types of movies. And the moderated variable is the country, which in our case is two countries, Germany and Italy. So in this case, we want to test whether a certain type of movie has a different effect on revenue in different countries. Well, let's first test this relationship. So this is the syntax that we used in the last video. Let's first create two dummy variables for the type of movie shown and the country. Let's encode. Horror. This one. We have to place horror between brackets because it is a genre one has is a string variable. Let's compare it with action into horror. So as you can see here are all labels of these different types, which are words. If we look at the type of variable, we see it's a string variable, so that's why we have to use the labels between brackets. So let's recode the country variable as well in a dummy variable. Let's make Germany 1 and Italy the reference category. So you see the transformations are pending. So now it is ready. We take the log revenue as a dependent variable, and we enter world. Let's first look at the simple model with only one variable included. Well, as you can see, the horror movies make 0.358 less log revenue than the action movies. So the constant in this model is the mean log revenue of the action movies. We could check it by doing a compare means. Log revenue, horror, yes. So as you can see, here you have the log revenue. Horror is zero. You see that the mean is exactly 13.72, which is exactly the constant level of the simple regression. Now let's add country. So now we see that here Germany has a higher log revenue than Italy, the movies that are shown in Germany, a 0.29 higher log revenue, holding horror constant. So meaning this increase in log revenue in Germany is similar, holds for as well as horror movies as action movies. Now of course we want to see whether that increase is different for those type of movies. So we need to compute an interaction effect between horror and Germany. So let's add this interaction or moderation term to the equation. So now we see that horror has a lower log revenue for both Germany and Italy. Germany has a higher log revenue for both horror and action movies. So the interaction effect between horror and Germany shows that a horror movie shown in Germany leads to a lower log revenue of 0.39. Now this means that for a horror movie shown in Italy, in Germany, you get an effect of 13.55, which is the constant, plus 1 times minus 0.15 for horror movie, plus 1.318, plus a minus 0.391. Let's move on to the moderation effect of a nominal and interval variable. So in this case, we want to test whether budget leads to a different movie revenue in different across different countries. So as you can see, Germany has a higher revenue than Italy. A 1 point increase in budget leads to a 0.012 increase in log revenue in both Germany and Italy. And a higher 1 million more budget in Germany leads to an additional 0.002 increase in log revenue. Now, if you would like to compute the entire effect for Germany and for a higher budget, you would have to add all these effects together. Now, the constant in this case reflects the mean level of log revenue where all the independent variables are zero. So in our case, that would mean this is the mean log revenue in Italy for an average budget. Let's continue with the moderation effect of two interval variables. In our case, we're going to use the variables of budget and runtime. So what we hypothesize is that the budget has a higher influence on revenue when the movie is shown for longer period of time. Look at how this runtime is distributed. Well, so as we can see, it's relatively normally distributed. A little bit skewed, that's for sure. Let's see if we can just use it in a normal linear regression. Let's first run the model without the interaction effects. So as we can see, the runtime in minutes, one extra minute, leads to a 0.004 increase in revenue, holding the budget constant, so for each budget the same increase. Then for a 1 point increase in budget, this leads to a 0.013 increase in log revenue. Let's see whether there's an interaction effect. As you can see, I added this multiplication of the runtime and budget to this equation. So the runtime still has 1 minute extra runtime leads to a 0.005 increase in the log revenue, holding the budget constant. For a 1 point increase in budget, it leads to a 0.016 increase in log revenue, holding the rest constant. And then the interaction, so when you have a 1 point increase in runtime and an increase in budget, it actually leads to an effect that's very close to zero. So if we would look at the effect, we see is a 0.00026 decrease in log revenue. Now this difference is so small that it's actually, we cannot see that it's different from zero. As you can look at the significance level, it's very high. Next, we will discuss mediation. So we teach you to use the macro, SPSS macro developed by Preacher and Hayes. So why is that? The coefficients using these macros are exactly the same as the linear regression estimates. However, the confidence interval differs for this interaction effect. In mediation, you can calculate this interaction effect by multiplying two coefficients. However, to obtain this confidence interval, Preacher and Hayes, they proposed to do a bootstrap analysis on your data. Now, bootstrapping is nothing less than taking, well, in this case, the minimum is 1,000 times. You take 1,000 times a sample from your sample, and you calculate the effect in each of these samples. Together, these estimates, these effects, they construct this confidence interval. Now let's show you how to implement this macro. First, you have to go to the website. So this is actually processmacro.org. You see here the menu downloads. You go to download, you click on this red button. You make sure that you extract the files in a location that you can, where you can find them. You go to this folder and you open this process syntax. So open with. You open the syntax, you select all and you run it. This will install the macro in your SPSS. So now it is ready. If we go to utilities, custom dialogs, you say you press on custom install custom dialog, it automatically finds this process underscore SPD file. You have to open it. Well, I actually already installed it. So here you get this window, dialog installed too. If you get the window, you can go to analyze, regression, and you will see an extra command labeled process. So if you press that button, you come into this menu where you can estimate such a mediation model. Now you see here model number 4. If you go to the files in the process, you will see one document, PDF document, that's called templates. And actually in this templates there are 76 models described that can be tested using this macro. Now, we are especially interested in this fourth model, where there's a mediate variable. Now, these labels that are mentioned here in the macro, they are exactly the same labels that are mentioned in the interface. So, Y and X and M is the mediator variable. So let us run a model where I take the log revenue as the outcome variable, the budget as an independent variable, and the number of screens as a mediating variable. So what I want to test is whether the effect of budget on log revenue can be explained by the number of screens in which the movie is shown. So let's press OK. This will let run the macro. So here we have the total output. It starts with describing the model, the relationship of budget to screens, so of the mediator to the outcome variable. The next model is a multiple regression analysis where the log revenue is explained, the y variable is explained by both the mediator variable and the x variable. And the last output, that's the most interesting output, is where the total model is described. So the direct effect of x on y is actually the same estimate as the one in this multiple regression analysis. And the indirect effect of x on y leading through the mediator variable is 0.0137, which is the exact result if you would multiply this effect of screens on log revenue times the effect of budget on screens, meaning x leading to m and m leading to y. So if you would multiply these two, you get exactly this result. Now, to learn whether this is significant, you have to look at this bootstrapped confidence interval, and you see that the zero is not included within this interval. So you know that this effect is significantly different from zero. You can be confident on a level of confidence of 95%. So 95% of all these bootstrapped samples lie within 0.012 and 0.015. Yeah, so the zero is not included, so we can be confident that the actual effect in the population is also not zero. Now, if you look at the other confidence interval, it actually is a similar meaning. So you see here the p-value is very high, but also the zero is included in this interval. So here I have an overview of all the steps that you need to take that I just executed for you in order to run this macro and to test the mediation model. So please pay attention that the mediator variable should be either ordinal, interval, or ratio level. You assume that it's a symmetric variable, so do not include nominal variables. If you do so, you need to adjust for this model. I think they also created models to do this, but make it easier on yourself and don't include a nominal variable.